Hi, I'm Kate. I'm about to guide you through Rank Math's URL inspection API integration with Google Search Console. You'll be able to understand the index status of the pages and discover any issues that might be preventing the page from being indexed right from your WordPress dashboard. We're going to cover how to activate this feature, then the three sections you'll find: top statuses, presence on Google, and index status result. If this feature doesn't appear as a tab in the Analytics section of Rank Math, you first need to activate the Analytics module in the dashboard. Then connect your website to your Google account with Rank Math. We have a video that shows how to do that in case you still haven't done it. Click on the card to watch it. Go to Rank Math's General Settings Analytics tab. The first section, Search Console, has the option Enable the Index Status tab. Click on the toggle to activate and save the changes. Now, let's check out the Index Status tab in Rank Math's Analytics. Once you've enabled the integration and saved the changes, Rank Math will start fetching data, and you may need to wait an hour to start seeing the initial results from the URL inspection API. From now on, Rank Math will update the index status every time it fetches new data from Google Analytics and Google Search Console, which is every 7 days for free users and 3 days for pro users. Currently, free users have a limit of 2,000 URLs, and pro users have a limit of 6,000 URLs that will be fetched in each schedule. We'll begin with the index statuses shown in Rank Math and what they correspond to in Google Search Console. Rank Math Pro users will find an overview of the index status of the pages overall in top statuses. The number of pages under each status appears when you hover your mouse over the pie chart, as well as listed on the right. Unspecified corresponds to no data available, which can happen sometimes if Google hasn't crawled this page yet. Pass means valid pages, which are the pages that are valid and have been indexed without issues or warnings. Partial corresponds to valid with warning. These pages have been indexed, but have issues that could lead to bad results if the warnings are ignored. Fail means error. These are the pages that haven't been indexed because something's wrong and need your immediate attention. Later in this tutorial, we'll go over specific error type descriptions in each page so you can know what's happening and how to fix it. Excluded corresponds to excluded from indexing. This status includes those URLs that are deliberately excluded from indexing by you, or the ones with duplicate content. Next, it's time to go over some of the most common status reasons. You can check out the Knowledge Base article that corresponds to this video for a full list of statuses. Rank Math Pro users will find them listed in the Presence on Google card. Submitted and indexed implies that the URL you've submitted through the sitemap was successfully indexed. Indexed not submitted in sitemap are the URLs Google discovered through means other than the sitemap, which have been indexed. URL is unknown to Google indicates that Google hadn't discovered this URL before and hasn't crawled it yet. Crawled, currently not indexed, means that Google has decided not to index the page for now. Discovered, currently not indexed, indicates that Google has discovered the page and even wants to crawl it, but doing that could have caused an overload on the site, so Google has rescheduled the crawl. Submitted URL marked no index indicates that you've submitted a page for indexing. However, something on the page, like a no index meta tag or HTTP header, instructs Google not to index this page. Indexed, though blocked by robots.txt, is for pages that your robots.txt blocked Google from crawling, but were linked to on another site. So even though Google respects the robots.txt file, it's managed to index this page anyway. It's also possible to just get blocked by robots.txt, which means the page hasn't been indexed because of the rules in the robots.txt file. So first you need to check by going to your website /robots.txt, or use Google's robots testing tool, which we've linked in the description. If you want the page to be indexed, you can check if the rules were written with Rank Math's general settings in the robots.txt tab. If they weren't, you'll need to make changes to the file via FTP. If you don't want the page to be indexed, instead of trying to block indexing with robots.txt, you need to set the page to no index. Open Rank Math's meta box in your page editor of choice and go to the Advanced tab. Then select No Index in the Robots Meta Tag area and update the page. If you can't find the Advanced tab in the meta box, make sure that the plugin is in Advanced mode on the upper right corner of the dashboard. If your sitemaps were created with Rank Math's sitemap module, once you set the page to No Index, it will be excluded from the sitemap. Four of the statuses are related to canonical tags. These tags tell search engines what URL to index in two cases. First, when the same page can be reached by different addresses, for example, with and without www. Second, when pages have very similar content. Rank Math adds a self-canonical tag by default to all pages, but you can assign a new address through the meta box in your page editor of choice. Open the Advanced tab, paste the URL in the canonical URL field and update the page. If you can't find the Advanced tab in the Meta box, make sure that the plugin is in Advanced mode on the upper right corner of the dashboard. If your sitemaps were created with Rank Math's sitemap module, once you add a canonical tag, the duplicate page will be excluded from the sitemap. Alternate page with proper canonical tag means that Google has recognized the canonical tag and sees this page as a duplicate. Duplicate without user-selected canonical suggests that Google has recognized this page and several other similar pages as duplicate, but none of them includes a canonical. We recommend explicitly marking the canonical page. Duplicate, Google chose different canonical than user, denotes that you've marked this page as canonical, but Google thinks another page could be a better choice for the page that will be indexed. Duplicate, submitted URL not selected as canonical, is shown when you don't use the canonical tag to indicate which URL should be indexed. Google will define which page to index on its own, and the duplicates will show this error. All Rank Math users will see a table with all the pages, posts, and custom post types in the website and the individual index status of posts. Rank Math Pro users can filter the posts by their index status using the drop-down menu at the top. When you select a specific status, you'll be able to see all the posts that share the same index status. Pro users also have advanced index stats, which we'll cover in detail later. All users can choose which columns to display to keep the table clutter-free. To add or remove columns, click on the three horizontal dots that you see in the top right and choose the columns you prefer. Some information is available exclusively for Pro users. The overall index status in the status column, as well as the columns crawled as, which indicates if the user agent that Google crawled this page with was a mobile or desktop device, and robot state, which shows whether the page is blocked for crawling or not. The other columns are available for all users. Indexing allowed indicates whether the page has an index or no index meta tag. Mobile usability checks whether the page clears the mobile usability test or not. Rich results indicates the rich snippets that Google has detected on the page. And page fetch indicates whether Google could retrieve your page from the server. Rank Math presents all the data in a table with a color code so you can understand the status of each page quickly. A green stamp with a tick means pass, an orange stamp with a tick means partial, a red stamp with an X means fail, and a gray stamp with a question mark means unspecified. Rank Math Pro users can dive deep into the indexing metrics and results for each post by clicking on the indexing status under its title. New fields will appear. Verdict provides information on whether the submitted page is indexed or not. Robot's text state indicates whether or not the page is blocked to Google by a robot's TXT rule. Depending on whether your robot's TXT file restricts the crawling of this page, you'd see one of three values. The two first, allowed and disallowed, correspond to the commands in the file. Third comes unspecified, which means that the page wasn't fetched or found, or that the robot's TXT file itself couldn't be reached. Indexing state shows there's a no index meta tag or HTTP header blocking indexing. This field can show unspecified, indexing allowed, blocked by meta tag, or blocked by HTTP header. Last crawl time shows the last time this URL was crawled by Google using the primary crawler, whether it's mobile or desktop. This result won't be available if the page still hasn't been crawled successfully. The page fetch state indicates whether Googlebot was able to retrieve the page from your server or not. There are several possible values. Unknown fetch state, successful fetch, 401, blocked due to unauthorized request, 403, blocked due to access forbidden, 404, not found, soft 404, blocked due to other code 4 issues that are neither 403 or 404, blocked by robots TXT, server error, which would be a code 5 followed by two other numbers, redirection error, internal error, and invalid URL. The next field, Google Canonical, indicates the canonical URL that Google has selected for the page. If the page isn't indexed, this result won't be available. On the other hand, the User Canonical field indicates the canonical URL that you've explicitly declared on the page. If the page doesn't include a canonical tag, this result will be unavailable. But, like we mentioned earlier, Rank Math would automatically add self-referencing canonical tags for all pages that are set as index. You can check whether the page is set to index or no index in the Advanced tab of Rank Math's Meta box, so you should probably find the post's own URL here. Sitemaps will show any known sitemaps that point to this page, that were submitted to Google through the Search Console or listed down in the robots TXT file. Any sitemap discovered through other means would not be listed. In referring URLs, you can find URLs that Google possibly used to discover this page. The referring page might have a direct link to this page or through a chain of linked pages. An empty field here just means that the referring pages may be inaccessible or that the URL inspection API was unable to pull this information for now. Moving on to crawled as, which shows if the primary crawler that Google has used to crawl this page was desktop or mobile. Mobile usability result tells you whether the page is mobile friendly or not. Since not all pages are tested for mobile usability, besides the pass or fail, you might also find not available as a value here. RankMath also displays any issues that might be hindering the page from being optimized for mobile devices. Last but not least, rich result types shows the rich results analysis. Information that was formatted to appear directly in search result pages, such as breadcrumbs or frequently asked questions. If there are no rich results found, you'll see it as absent. If this tutorial helped you, give it a like. If you have any questions, click on the link in the description to open a free support ticket. You can find other tutorials in our knowledge base at rankmath.com/kb.